The world is changing. People have new tools to communicate and to be part of this change. Yesterday, journalism was centralized, top-down, oligarchic, and nepotistic. But now, journalism has changed. And you?
Buffet counters on the Zimbabwe Stock Exchange, which are epitomized by the so-called odd mutual implied exchange rate. This in turn results in four or more US-based bond parallel market exchange rates operating in the market. At any time, therefore, there is the official rate, an EcoCash rate, a one-money rate, and odd mutual rate, among others. As the Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe governor aptly observed recently, there are multiple contrived phantom exchange rates in use in the Zimbabwe economy, which conspire to defeat fiscal policy. Statement issued by Nick Mangwana, Secretary for Information, Publicity and Broadcasting Services. Government has with immediate effect undertaken a series of prudent and coordinated interventions to deal with malpractices, criminality, and economic sabotage perpetuated by the wolves in sheepskins amongst our population that His Excellency the President alluded to during his official address on the occasion of the hero's burial of Comrade Stanley Nleya at the National Shrine. These measures include the suspension of all monetary transactions on phone-based mobile money platforms in order to facilitate intrusive investigations leading to the arrest and prosecution of offenders. Concurrently, the measures will also include the suspension of all trading on the Zimbabwe Stock Exchange. These measures are to subsist until such time that the mobile money platforms have been reformed to their original purpose and all the current phantom rates of exchange have converged into one genuine rate that is determined by market forces under the foreign currency auction system, which was launched by the Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe on 23 June 2020. Operational modalities and details of the envisaged measures are going to be announced by the relevant monetary, regulatory and law enforcement authorities in the next few days. Government will concurrently ensure that prudent measures are also put in place to mitigate and prevent any collateral damage that these interventions may cause to the innocent transacting public who were using these platforms. Government is in possession of impeccable intelligence, which constitutes a prima facie case whereby the phone-based mobile money systems of Zimbabwe are conspiring with the help of the Zimbabwe Stock Exchange either deliberately or inadvertently in illicit activities that are sabotaging the economy. These activities include illegal externalization of foreign currency through transfer malpractices, acting as banks outside the papers for which they were originally licensed as non-banking financial institutions. This includes in this particular case of EcoCash holding well in excess of $8 billion distributed across just over 501,000 agent lines as at 10 June 2020, which is not under the scrutiny of the Financial Intelligence Unit. Fraudulent creating and issuing non-attributable and non-auditable agent cell phone lines, hiding irreconcilable accounts in suspense accounts, which hold huge credit balances for unjustifiably long periods. EcoCash in particular is acting as the center pivot of the galloping black market foreign exchange and therefore fueling the incessant price hikes of goods and services that are bedeviling the economy and causing untold hardship to the people of Zimbabwe. In this regard, it has been conspiring with big merchants to act as their conduit through which they transfer hundreds of millions of dollars per day to runners on the street who then buy US dollars on their behalf. Facilitating illicit trade in notes and coins at a contrived rate of between 30% and 50%, thus causing artificial shortages of the same within the banking system. Rampant, often arrogant non-compliance with directives issued by the Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe and the Financial Intelligence Unit. criminally allowing urgent lines that were banned by the Reserve Bank of Zimbabwe continue trading illegally, using bulk airtime sales at discounted prices, which are cross-rated to Fatum USD exchange rates, which further distort the Zimbabwe market and deliberately mop up US dollars from the black market, thus forcing up the rate of exchange in a manner that has hitherto been difficult to explain for the monetary authorities. Engaging in rampant unchecked tax evasion, failure to report suspicious transactions or to take action against them, creation of illegal transient and permanent money through airtime loans, unaccounted wallet-to-wallet bank-to-bank transactions, and other malpractices. Maintaining unauditable mobile phone lines or accounts which are being used by criminal syndicates in convenience with insiders to steal money from subscribers through such fraudulent practices as teaming and lending. We are reporting for Blasting News here in Zimbabwe. Please stay tuned for more news.